I'm here at Walmart and I'm gonna run in and grab a few things. I need to get some stuff. I'll try and film the skincare section because it's been a hot minute since we've been in there. But we'll see how that goes, what with distancing and whatnot. But I'm gonna try and score some cash back on the Drop app. Today's video is in partnership with the Drop app. You guys know I'm a huge fan of that bad boy. I'm always getting cash back. But yeah, haven't been in Wally World in a long time. So we'll see if I got anything new in terms of skincare. Seriously though, Drop is the easiest rewards app to use. Basically, you get points for shopping at places that you love, like Walmart, Sephora, Apple. Those points then can turn into gift cards that you can use to buy more stuff at places that you like Sephora, ASOS. Whenever you shop online, definitely use the Drop app before you shop online. Yeah, it's pretty easy. You just go to the shop page and then you tap on the offer that you're interested in and you tap shop now. And you shop as you ordinarily would. You complete the checkout process as you ordinarily would within the store's website. And then Drop automatically adds points to your account. For example, I recently purchased things from Walmart and I got a ton of points back, and I'm gonna cash those bad boys in to get more Walmart purchases. So yeah, it's great. Plus Drop has a lot of like low friction ways to easily acquire points just by doing like little surveys and fun games and stuff within the app. But if you use the link in my description box and download the Drop app, once you download the Drop app, you will be rewarded $10 in the form of 10,000 points. Those points you will acquire those points once you earn your first 1,000 points within the Drop app that you can then use to cash in on a gift card. And I've gotten so many great gift cards that I've been able to buy things. But definitely take advantage of it now by clicking the link in my description box, because the offer for the $10 is only available for 1 week. So go ahead and get on that if you were interested in the Drop app. But yeah, anyways, I'm gonna head on into a Walmart.
Looks like we have an Equate Beauty dupe of Neutrogena's Ultra Sheer Dry Touch. I'm trying to talk through a mask, so I don't know how the audio is gonna go here. But FYI, SPF 100, it turns out, is actually better at protecting you from a burn in real life use in comparison to SPF 50. But I will have to warn you that a chemical sunscreen like this is probably, I'm almost certain, gonna burn around the eyes, which is unfortunate, because you definitely want to put sunscreen around the eyes. So it is a good one for protecting you against a burn. You guys, they have the Neutrogena Rapid Wrinkle Repair Regenerating Cream fragrance free here. This is bomb diggity, yo. I've been listening to too much 90s rap in the car on the way over here. But yeah, this is really good. If you're looking for a retinol, it is a sustained action, slow release retinol. It minimizes the irritation that you experience with the retinol. So that's great. And it can be used to improve the look of wrinkles and fine lines. And Neutrogena really does diligence by their retinol. They've actually shown in lab studies that it does in fact activate the molecular markers of retinol activity in the skin. Now they also combine the sustained action retinol with vitamin C and an SPF. Boy, there's a whole lot going on in here. Their SPF is gonna sting and burn around around your eyes. What else? Got the retinol. What does it have in the way of vitamin C? And it also has ascorbic acid. L-ascorbic acid definitely has been shown to improve wrinkles and fine lines as well, and also has been shown to improve hyperpigmentation. Unfortunately, it's not super stable, and it's been shown to be maximally effective in the presence of ferulic acid and vitamin E. So I don't see that in here. So I don't know how worthwhile the vitamin C in this is, but it is L-ascorbic, which is the one that's been shown to be effective, unlike those stabilized ones like THD. THD sounds like a street drug, doesn't it? This looks like an eye cream, but it's just a little mini. Apparently masks are optional here. I'm like the only one wearing one, you guys. I always get questions about this Earth to Skin line. I don't recommend any of it. It's just glorified perfume. Now, the Clean Beauty line has a few good men. Awesome. This doesn't appear to have fragrance. I'm getting it. It is a zinc oxide sunscreen. This is probably going to leave a cast. You do need to put this around your eyes, though. Don't forget to put it there. I'm going to get this and give it a whirlsy. Let's not say we did with this papaya thing. What are we, a fruit salad? No. Again, acai face scrub. A rose hip jelly. Just riding that rose hip gravy train, aren't we? Bladder whack. And geraniol, that's fragrance. Yeah, let's skip that. White clay face bar. Clay is good if you have oily skin. It helps kind of mop up oiliness. Yeah, this looks promising for those of you with oily skin. Inga body butter. This reminds me of the Body Shop's body butters. I always enjoyed those. This is one of the few fragrance-containing products that I frequently recommend, just because it's so hard to find hydroquinone-containing products that don't have fragrance in them, aside from like PCA Skin, which is just kind of expensive. I mean, it's good, but it's expensive. So this is actually what I end up... This is a hydroquinone I frequently end up recommending to people looking to improve dark spots. It's pretty good. It gets you what you could expect with hydroquinone. It improves it while you're using it. You can't use it indefinitely. After using it about 6 months, then you stop and eventually the dark spots come back. But it's actually useful if you feel a pimple coming on and you know it's going to heal with a dark mark. If it's not too irritating, go ahead and start putting it on at that point, because it can put the melanocytes kind of to sleep for a bit and reduce the chances of the pimple healing with a dark mark. But unfortunately, it can be pretty irritating, so it's a delicate balance. It's a delicate balance. I feel like I have a stuffy nose, but it's just the mask. Oh, you guys, I love this ultralight moisturizing lotion by CeraVe. It's just like kind of overpriced for what it is. It's a chemical sunscreen, SPF 30, but it looks great on the skin. You just burn through it really quickly. Is it $6.96? Am I reading that wrong? Getting a little lightheaded here. It's another respectable bar soap. You know, I think I may have in my earlier videos been a little harsh on bar soaps. They can be super drying if you choose the wrong one. This one's actually pretty decent, and is one I frequently recommend. Bierstorff does a good job with skincare. They make like, they're the used trend folks. So yeah, the Basis bar is good. The Purpose one can be a little drying. And does it have fragrance? I believe it does. Yeah, Basis one is good if you're into bar soaps. Now, speaking of bar soaps that are good, I love the Hydrating Cleanser Bar from CeraVe. That's another good one. Equate needs to start duping the good stuff. Like, why don't they dupe this? Or maybe they did, and it's just out. Now, the Equate Beauty dupe for CeraVe's Hydrating Cleanser is no bueno, folks. Don't waste your time on this. I've always just assumed that generics are just as good as brand name, but they screwed this up. In my opinion, it was not good. It just like, it had a weird consistency and it didn't cleanse the same way that CeraVe does. CeraVe's reliable in terms of removing, catch my breath, in terms of removing makeup, but this was just not useful. Likewise, the Foaming Facial Cleanser by Equate. Yeah, don't waste your time on that. It's not a good one. Olay also has their Retinol 24 fragrance-free. Hallelujah. This is another option. I don't think it's as good as the Neutrogena one. But it's got peptides in it, which can help smooth out wrinkles and fine lines as well. And, a serum version. This is just going to be more lightweight. And it's in a cage. You see the allure of serum, like this marketing of serum? It makes it sound like more regal, so they have to put it in a cage as opposed to this. I mean, it's just basically the same thing, just different consistencies, and one gets a cage and the other is free to walk away. I reviewed this in a dedicated video, which I'll link down below. It was okay. I wouldn't really say it was intense hydration while one sleeps. See, like, they love this whole night recovery marketing, which, again, there is some truth to that. I have a video explaining basically your skin still has to deal with the insult of UV damage throughout the day. There's evidence that there's ongoing damage to the DNA in your melanocytes into the nighttime. So, you know, there is some truth to this marketing around night recovery, especially stuff that has antioxidants in it, which theoretically could help combat that. Yeah. What did this even have in it? This had peptides in it, which can help hydrate. I mean, it really wasn't much beyond a basic moisturizer.
And like, Olay wants to be like some kind of cool kid, so they charge like $30 for a tub of goo, which is like no better than anything else. But I think it will give it a lure, I guess.
All right, Copper Tone has a oil-free SPF 50 chemical sunscreen. This is great. It doesn't have any fragrance. It's not going to leave a cast. It will burn around your eyes because it's a chemical sunscreen. It is water resistant, and it also has aluminum starch in it. So if you have oily skin, that'll help to decrease oiliness. This is great, and I recommend it, aside from the fact that it will burn, sting around your eyes. But yeah, this is a great one to give a whirl for your face. It will stay in place because it's water resistant, so it's less likely to run into your eyes. But yeah, it definitely can sting around the eyes, unfortunately. I don't know how I feel about those knives by Pioneer Woman. Hey, isn't that cute? Little ceramic Dutch oven. You guys know me and my pink kitchenware.
Well, hey guys, I'm back from Walmart. I just put my laundry in, so that's what that slushy sound is in the background. I did, in fact, purchase this clean SPF 30 zinc oxide sunscreen. I thought I would give it a try, Z, here on camera. Zinc oxide-based sunscreens are arguably the best for people with sensitive skin, but they're really good overall in general. And zinc oxide is one of two ingredients that are approved for use in sunscreens that will protect us against UVA-1 here in the United States. Throughout Europe, and in Canada, Australia, New Zealand, they have other filters, and throughout Asia, they have other filters that will protect them against those rays. But here we only have avobenzone and zinc oxide. And a lot of people will fixate on the percentage of zinc oxide and try and deduce efficacy of the product from the percentage, but that's not helpful, necessary, or accurate. The percentage of zinc oxide will vary a lot depending on the size of the zinc, if it's coated or not, and the inactive ingredients overall. And really what you need to focus on in terms of zinc oxide sunscreens is just look at the SPF. An SPF 50 zinc oxide sunscreen is equally effective regardless of the percentage of zinc oxide to another zinc oxide based sunscreen that has a lower percentage or whatever. It varies a lot depending on multiple things. So analyzing the percentages, it's not accurate, useful, or helpful. This product looked promising to me for people with sensitive skin. It also looks promising to me for people to use around their eyes, because if anything, even if you don't have particularly sensitive skin, a lot of the chemical sunscreens really burn and sting around the eyes. And so I always recommend choosing a zinc oxide based sunscreen. Baby sunscreens are often zinc oxide, and they are a good choice, and they tend to be pretty inexpensive. So yeah, that's another one. But let's just see what this looks like. It's pretty thick. Feels nice. I can tell though, it's probably not gonna work out well for people who have. I was gonna say for people who have phototypes 4, 5, and 6, still gonna be casty. I don't know, this isn't too bad. Yeah, people will say, well, how is it that
how is it that they can get sunscreens that have transparent, that are zinc oxide, that are sheer and transparent, don't leave much of a cast, then if the percentage doesn't matter, how is that protecting you? It has to do with Z-Coat came out, I can't remember when, like many, many years ago. And basically it's smaller size zinc oxide particles that allow for basically a transparent zinc formulation, which is what you're getting here, even though you see that cast. It's not like old school zinc oxide. This will in fact protect you against UVA 1 and UVA 2, both aspects of UVA, those rays that come through the window and destroy your collagen and whatnot. See, our sunscreens here in the States are kind of willy-nilly about that. Zinc oxide is one of the more reliable of the two ingredients because avobenzone has to be stabilized in order to protect you well against UVA. It degrades, basically, and so you start losing protection. But honestly, you guys, this is not bad. This isn't terrible. Feels good. I'm just gonna do the other cheek. And I'm putting it on top of, I put on sunscreen before I left to go to Walmart. I put on the Dermatology SPF 46. Now that is a combination sunscreen. It has zinc and then it has a chemical filter. Whereas this is just a mineral sunscreen. It only has zinc. There's no chemical filters. So for people with really sensitive skin, this is even better. But honestly, the combination sunscreens, they don't tend to be as irritating as the straight up chemical sunscreens. I just took a peek in the mirror. I can't really tell in the viewfinder, but in the mirror, this seems fairly sheer with a hint of a white cast, but it does also seem pretty shiny. So I don't know how well. Oftentimes things look a certain way in the viewfinder and then I put the footage in the computer and they look totally different. So at least peeking in the mirror over here, it seems like it's a pretty subtle cast, but it is really shiny. So for those of you who have oily skin, I don't know that you're gonna care for this. I'm not too sure that makeup would go on over this so well, but I actually kind of like it, I don't know. And I only applied it to my lower half like this so you guys could get a sense of the cast and kind of how it looks. I don't know, it's not too bad, but again, I never know until I get this in the computer what it actually looks like, and then I'm like. But yeah, I kind of like it. It feels really good on the skin. Only time will tell. Comment below on if you've used this or anything else by this clean brand. They have a few good men. some of their products seem really promising. I'll put the price here. I have to go look at the receipt. Anyways, guys, I'm gonna wrap up the vid here. I hope you all enjoyed it. Shopping with me as best we were able in Walmart with the distancing, but I hope you all enjoyed it nonetheless. And don't forget to download the Drop app, link in the description box. Thank you, Drop, for sponsoring a portion of today's video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends. And as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.